Hello, and welcome to this presentation, Understanding VOR. In this short presentation, we'll explain what VOR is, the role of VOR in aviation, basic VOR navigation, and the structure of signals generated by VOR stations. VOR stands for VHF Omnidirectional Range, and is a navigational aid or nav aid used in aviation. VOR can be used for both on-route navigation, essentially flying between airports, and during approach and landing. In fact, the traditional system of low-altitude airways in the United States are called Victor Airways because they were defined using VOR. As the name implies, VOR stations operate at VHF frequencies, from 108 to about 118 MHz. These frequencies are also sometimes given as channel numbers as per ICAO, the International Civilian Aviation Organization. For example, 117.2 MHz is ICAO channel 119. There are VOR stations throughout the United States, and a VOR may be located either on or off an airport facility. Additionally, VOR stations are also categorized by their range. A terminal VOR normally has a range of about 25 miles. Low and high altitude VORs have typical ranges of 40 and 100 miles, respectively. It's also worth noting that the majority of VORs are paired, that is, physically co-located, with a DME station or a TACAN station, the latter being called a VORTAC. VOR type is usually indicated in the FAA chart supplement. VOR is a one-way system in which stations transmit signals that are received by aircraft. VOR is based on the concept of radials, which are defined in all directions, hence the term omnidirectional. These are around the station from 0 to 359 degrees and are referenced to magnetic north. For example, the 290 radial is 290 degrees east of magnetic north. Using the signals from a VOR station, an aircraft can determine which of that station's radials that it's currently on. Note that this radial can be expressed in two ways, either as the bearing to or from a station. In this example, the aircraft is on the 290 from radial, but this would also be expressed as the 70 degree to radial. The aircraft is at an angle of 290 degrees from the station, and the angle to the station from the aircraft is 70 degrees. On aeronautical charts, a VOR is surrounded by a compass rose that shows the radials. Remember that the radials of a VOR are oriented towards magnetic north, not geographic north, so the zero radial will usually not be pointing exactly straight up. One important thing to remember is that VOR indicates the radial that the aircraft is on, not the aircraft's current heading. This red line represents the 95 radial from this VOR. Although each of these aircraft have different headings, they are all on the same radial and will have identical VOR indicators. Since many approach procedures and airways were originally designed around VOR radials, one of the most basic ways a VOR is used is intercepting and flying along a certain radial of a given VOR. Let's look at an example. A pilot needs to fly along the 87 radial as part of an approach. The pilot first tunes the frequency of the on-field VOR and audibly confirms the VOR's identity via Morse or voice ID. The pilot then sets the VOR receiver to 87, looks at the needle, and adjusts his or her course until the desired radial has been intercepted. To fly along that radial, the pilot simply ensures that the VOR needle stays centered. We can also determine our current position using two different VORs. Let's look at how this works. At this location, the aircraft is receiving signals from two different VOR stations, VOR1 and VOR2. The VOR1 indicator shows the plane is exactly south of the station, or on the 180 degree radial. The VOR2 indicator shows that the plane is exactly west of the station, or on the 270 degree radial. Since our chart shows the VOR locations, we can easily determine our current position. Now let's take a look at VOR signals and how they can be used to determine which radial we're on. All VOR stations transmit a carrier that's modulated by two 30 Hz signals. The first of these is the reference signal, which has the same phase regardless of which radial we're on. The second signal is the variable signal, whose phase is different on each radial due to the design of the VOR station antenna. We can determine which radial we're on by looking at the difference between the reference and variable signals. For example, if the phase difference between reference and variable signals is 45 degrees, this means that we are on the 4-5 radial. Let's look at a few more examples of the relationship between phase difference and radial. On the 0-degree radial, the phase difference between the reference and variable signals will be 0 degrees. On the 9-0 radial, the phase difference between these signals is 90 degrees. Similarly, on the 180 radial, we will see a 180-degree phase difference between the reference and variable signals. And on the 270 radial, we see, unsurprisingly, a phase difference of 270 degrees. Let's take a closer look at the VOR signal in the frequency domain. The variable signal is AM modulated and centered on the nominal VOR frequency F sub 0. The reference signal is FM modulated and can be found 9.9 kHz above and below this frequency. There's also a COM ID signal that appears twice in spectrum at 1020 Hz above and 1020 Hz below the center frequency F sub 0. The VOR COM ID is used to audibly identify a VOR station. In the United States, there are several hundred VOR stations, but only 80 VOR frequencies, so it's important to be sure that the signal we're receiving is from the desired station. At high altitudes and under certain atmospheric conditions, the signal from a distant VOR could be inadvertently received. The COM ID can be either Morse code or recorded voice. If a VOR is Morse code only, this is indicated by underlining the VOR frequency on the chart. If we fail to receive the proper ID, this could be due to the VOR being out of range, inoperable, or perhaps our radio is tuned to the wrong frequency. So in summary, VOR stands for VHF Omnidirectional Range, and is a navigational aid or nav aid used in aviation. VOR allows aircraft to determine which radial of a VOR station they're on. In other words, the bearing to the VOR from the aircraft or vice versa. A VOR signal has three components: a reference signal, a variable signal, and a COM ID signal. Radial is determined by looking at the phase difference between the reference and variable signals, and the COM ID is used to positively identify a VOR station. This concludes our presentation, Understanding VOR. Thanks for watching.